Hello everyone, welcome to Exademy, Redefining Education. I am Devdutta Kulkarni and today we are going to look into how to download ANSYS and the user interface of the ANSYS. So first of all, to download the ANSYS, open Google in your browser window and in the search bar type ANSYS download. Open the first link which appears. Free student version, free student software, click on it, scroll down, we'll find ANSYS student, click on it, scroll down again, click on download ANSYS student 2019 R1, a pop-up window will appear, just click on agree and download. Wait for the download to get started. You can see that the zip file of 4.3 GB is getting downloaded. I have already downloaded the files, but you have to wait until the download finishes. Open the download location. You will find the zip file. Extract that zip file using the extractor of your choice. I have already extracted these files. Open the folder and find the setup.exe file. Double click on it. Wait for the ANSYS setup window to appear. So this is the ANSYS setup window. Click on I agree option. Then next, here you can select the installation directory, then click on next, wait for the setup to finish up to 100%. After finishing the setup, you can open the file from the start menu, scroll down and find the ANSYS. Here you can see that the various ANSYS modules have been installed. Find the workbench and click on it. ANSYS takes some time to load up all the components. Let it finish. Once the loading finishes, you will find the workbench window as shown, which appears. Here you can see that this toolbox contains various modules of the ANSYS. Then there is project schematic. Then there is properties of project schematic. These are some of the default layouts. Here is a ready button. Here is a job monitor option. Here is a show progress. And then here is show messages. Then there are other options in the toolbar, such as file, view, tools, units, extensions, jobs, help. So basically, using file option, you can create the new project. Open the existing project, save your project, save as, import the project or export the report, archive the project and etc. Using view, you can refresh your workbench. You can choose which toolbox or toolboxes should appear, such as this. Open and close windows, you can use the view option. Tools options lets you do the various other customizations such as appearance, language, graphic interaction, and various other options in modules. Then there is units. You can change to SI or US units or metric units. Also, you can click on unit systems to check the various other available units, import or export the units. Then there is extension option. Then there is job monitor and help. So to start a project, you basically just need to drag and drop the module, such as I will select the steady state thermal module, drag and drop it on project schematic window. Once you do that, you will see that a following window appears. Here you have various options such as engineering data, geometry, model, setup, solution, results. Right clicking on these options will give options such as edit, duplicate, transfer the data, update the data, rename, properties, add note, various options. For any model to update, you have to just drag it, select it, and drag it. By following these procedures, you can start working on the ANSYS projects. So this is basically a workflow where we have to set up the geometry or engineering data at first as per the project, then mesh, then set up the files, then solution, and post-process the results. We will look into each of these files in detail in the next videos.